Yeah. Even this one where, I mean, come on, we're reminiscing and bro talking. I like your nipples, bro.
Dude, your nipples are way better though. Like, on a scale of 1 to 10.
I'm not a huge fan of my nipples, I'll keep it real. Happy birthday to me!
Happy birthday to me!
That was the most conceited birthday song that I think I've ever sang. Welcome on back to the Pokemon Heart Gold and Soul Silver Naruto themed souling. Today is Monday. If you missed the last episode, it's up on Tobin's channel on Friday, and the next episode will be on Tobin's channel tomorrow because the schedule of the series is Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday.
There you go.
Alternating between the two channels.
You
love to see it.
You did it.
We are 19 episodes into this project, bro. Can you believe it?
No, because I thought we were literally going to be ending like 3 episodes ago, but then we were like, no, what? No more speed up.
I don't see the problem with no more speed up. Have you ever seen a Chugga Conroy Let's Play with no speed up, Tobin?
I like it better, but it was just funny because like we were like flying through it, and then we're like, all right, let's take our time.
I don't know, my dude. Okay. Like, I kind of like it, though.
You know, I like it.
I do. It makes these series such more of, like, a vibe where we're just hanging. Like, the game it's here. I don't know.
You know, I like it a lot. I've been having fun these past few episodes with no speed up. Like, every now and then, if it gets a little, like, annoying, like flying somewhere real quick, like, speed up's nice. But, like, this is fine. I like this.
Guys, Tobin absolutely hates it.
No, I haven't used speed up in a series literally since, like,
guys, I see the veins like just like popping and fuming.
No, dude, I haven't done speed up in like a
dude. I see him rubbing his chinny chin chin like an evil Disney villain. Like, dude, he's plotting my demise.
I have a problem with plucking my hair. I'm sorry. I feel
hair while you think of my demise, Tobin. I'm scared,
dude. No, like I actually have a problem. Like, it's actually like I don't know what it's called, but it's actually like
it's called I hate Ryan. Problem.
No.
Yo, I know that we were like brainstorming fun stream ideas to do together in the last episode, like Mario Party with me, Frank, and Dylan, but like I might need to call that off if you're gonna kill me. I'm gonna be back in like a second. Entertain the people.
Okay, well, since he's leaving, I'm looking up right now. What is the thing called when you pluck your hair? Because I know there's it's like not a disease, obviously, but there's like a twit. Plucking hair, best locations. No. Hair removal. The types of hairs you should do, not be plucking. What you need to know about tweezing. No. I don't know what it's called. Oh!
Hi!
Wait.
Yo, what's up? What's good?
Wait, when someone is able to stop pulling hair, usually grows back. No. There is something where like... Oh, yeah, I found it.
I don't know what you found.
This is what I have if my Wi-Fi will load. Our Wi-Fi has been really bad here lately. It's been so annoying, but... There is an actual a disorder for what I have. It's called...
Oh, my God.
It is called... Okay, I'm... No thanks to you. Okay, it's called trichotillomania. And it's also known as hair pulling disorder. It's a type of impulse control disorder. People who have... have an irresistible urge to pull out their hair. Usually from their scalp, eyelashes, and eyebrows. I don't do that. I do my eyebrows. I pluck my unibrow.
Really?
Yeah, I pluck my unibrow and I pluck my beard hair.
Okay. What is the standard procedure to get it treated? All right, like what's the course of action that we're gonna take now that we're actually like questioning if you have this?
Give me a cone head, like dogs, you know, so they can't scratch themselves. I can get that.
If it works, it works, man. All right, like so straight up, what I'm thinking is for my birthday here. Okay. Heart Gold, Soul Silver, Soul Link, vlog to the Petco, and you know, go buy Tobin a cone neck. Come on. Happy birthday to me.
I'm just saying, that'd be the funniest, like, thumbnail.
It just intro moment ever. Oh my God, just cone Tobin, like.
Just, hey guys, just a fat cone.
Full cone swag, bro.
I honestly need it. One though, like, it's really bad. Because the thing that's with me, what I do is, I'll feel my beard. And if one hair just feels a little bit longer than the rest, which is going to happen with hair, I pluck it. But the thing is, it's you don't stop because no hairs are even. Like,
yeah, it's really bad. Dude. I'm just going to keep it. I'm not the best with facial hair. I'll only like start trying to manage it if I'm going to need to go somewhere like PAX or something like that. You know?
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'll just kind of like go through a cycle of going babyface. Eventually, I'll let it kind of like grow out a little bit, so we'll get like a 5 o'clock shadow, like stubble look.
Yeah.
And then I've learned that I can't go any thicker than that. It just doesn't look good at that point.
Yeah. See, so, I just get lazy. I wake up and I'm like, I don't want to have to shave my face right now. So I let it grow. But then that's the problem. I don't like having super long hair in my face. So that's when I start plucking, and then it just gets me in a really bad cycle.
I still can't tell for me if I look good or better or whatever with stubble or just straight baby face.
I don't know. I think it's pretty even to me for you.
Like, yeah, like I wouldn't say that one's better than the other. Yeah, I just kind of gotten used to switching back and forth between them. I got a new razor not too long ago though, with freaking razor heads on them that can let me change like the thickness.
Oh yeah.
Of the freaking, yeah, dude, I can go between like 5 inches or 1 inch or whatever. See, the hell.
I have this.
Yo. Oh, Tobin, show me what. Whip it out, Tobin. Show me what you got. Whip it out. Whip it out. Birthday sex. Whip it out. Whip it out. Why are we razor reveal? Short-tempered razor reveal. Oh God. Oh God.
I have the Manscaper.
Oh, okay. That's a name.
It's called the lawnmower.
That's another name. Oh my God.
And it's
really
like good.
I got a weed whacker in the garage. You got the same trick, I guess. But like, oh God.
This right here, you want to know this is for?
What's it for?
Shaving your testicles.
Yeah, there it is. I mean, you said Manscaped. I should have known, man. Like, sometimes I'll whip out the chainsaw and get the same job done, but I guess you just... Hey, yo, Dad, go get the machete. I gotta, you know...
I gotta shave my testicles, Dad. Come on.
I gotta take care of the business downstairs. You know what I'm saying?
That's what Vinny probably needs. This man probably needs a full-on lawnmower. You just run on his stomach.
God, I don't even want to know, dude. He doesn't just shave his testicles. That's just called deforestation right there.
Oh, my God.
Like, literally, low-key. Why is it the Amazon rainforest? Save the trees. Wasn't that Mr. Beast's thing? Was he not thinking about Vinny's pubes during that time?
He definitely was. Side note. I gotta get dressed. You know, I gotta get naked to put on my like boxers and stuff like that, right?
As we all do, yes. Yes.
So this morning when I was doing that, Bentley likes to watch me while I do it. Kinda cute. But then today he was in a playful mood. So when I was completely naked, he jumped up to like climb on me and he just scratched my penis. And it hurt so bad.
You really don't care what you talk about in Soul Link episodes, do you? Jesus,
I
know.
I talk about whatever funny in my life, you know?
Bro, right on the shaft.
Jeez. Yeah, right. Like, it hurt. Like, he just went, I was like, ow.
You know, I think I hear you say more bad things about this dog than good things. Oh, my God.
No, he's really cute. Baby!
No. You can't play with him for the sympathy points. He scratched your dick, dude. Come on, that's your manhood.
Look at him. Look how cute
Scratch
he is.
His dick back. Dick for dick, scratch for scratch.
It's wet. I'm not going to touch it right now. He went pee outside.
Okay, all right. Well, didn't you just get out of the shower?
Yeah.
Was your dick wet?
No, because I was dried. And I took a poop after my shower, so it was definitely dry.
I understand. So hear me out, Tobin. This is our last encounter before the Elite Four. All that I have left is the Master Ball. Should I fly back and go buy balls or just do the encounter?
Yeah, I'm way behind you, so I would definitely go do that.
Fine. Guys, Tobin doesn't want to go to Kanto, and it kind of upsets me.
I just don't want to do it in the record. Like, we can do it live. I'm cool with that.
Yeah, but that's just a live stream, Tobin.
I want more episodes.
I want more consistent videos, bro.
Kanto's, like, just really boring to me, like, in this game.
This series has not been gameplay focused, like, at
all.
Yeah,
but it's more, like, when I'm having fun in the game, I'm having fun in real life. You know what I mean?
And we're going to have fun together.
A live stream will be
Goofy
fun.
Goofy shenanigans. We can have a Disney Channel sitcom, Tobin.
Hey, this is Tobin. You're watching Disney Channel.
Yeah. Yo, what was your favorite Disney Channel sitcom? Hit me with it. Go.
What is sitcom? I need a definition.
A show that has a laugh track. Multicam show with a laugh track.
Probably Hannah Montana.
What the hell? No, nobody knows Hannah Montana.
Hannah Montana was so good.
I'm not saying it was bad. I'm just saying it wasn't the best, dude. You got your freaking Good Luck Charlie. That's number one.
No.
Bro, that show was so funny.
Dude, that was like the transitioning to like where Disney got really bad.
What do you mean?
Like, that was like it was all right. Then after that, it was
just really
bad.
Like, the shows afterward weren't that great. But Good Luck Charlie, I would call the last good show. Okay, Wizards. Sweet Life.
No, I would say, to me, it's Hannah Montana, Sweet Life, Wizards. That's my list.
Tobin.
What?
You hurt my feelings.
I like Sweet Life, guys. It was the funniest one, especially when they went to On Deck. That was even better because that means they were on the water.
Glad you got that out for the people. Was that important for you?
Yes.
Been on your mind that long? That whole series you wanted to wait for Naruto Solo?
I wanted to talk about Sweet Life on Deck.
All right, fine. Let's have an entire Sweet Life on Deck podcast conversation, all right? Straight up, I thought that the show was a little bit weird when they brought in Marcus. I didn't think that he entirely worked for the show. Like, it didn't not work, but it just didn't totally work.
Yeah, he was kind of annoying, to be honest. Because he was the guy with the
He was the rapper kid. He ended up being Zach's roommate. I think they just wanted to give a roommate to Zach, I'll be real.
Yeah, to be honest, yeah, he was weird. But Bailey?
Yeah, no, her relationship with Cody was super, super cute.
She was awesome.
It really was. Dude, didn't they get rid of Woody like halfway into the series? Wasn't he a main character and then just like stopped being main character and then came back or something?
Which one are you talking about?
Marcus is from Sweet Life on Deck and he was that's the cruise ship show. He was the rapper guy.
He's not the guy with the braces?
No, the guy with the braces, that was Woody.
Mm. All right, I forget who Marcus is.
Marcus was the rapper kid.
I don't remember the rapper kid.
Come on, dude. Apparently, this Disney Channel Sweet Life sitcom conversation was such a big deal, and you were like, yo, I want to make sure that I get my thoughts out for the people. I want to make sure that they know this. You couldn't let me just finish typing my timestamp. You're like, yeah, I had to talk about Sweet Life. So here we go. I'm having the talk. I'm having the Sweet Life talk.
Yeah, I need to. Also, I should have not took up my HM Slave. I have nothing for strength now. Just kidding. I have Grungy. We're good.
I'm just kind of throwing HMs on whatever mons at this point. I'm using my deer, and I'm enjoying my deer. All right, that's just.
Are you not using your legendary Cresselia?
I mean, the legendary Cresselia is there, but like the deer is definitely the carrying, like driving force of the series.
This is good.
Like we all thought it was gonna be Wormadam, and we really hyped up that MVP.
This is good.
Wait, does that work? It's a fire type. Does that work?
I don't have a fire type. I don't think.
Yo, fire fam! I think we just got a fire type.
Yo, bet.
Yo, temper tantrums. No Charmanders allowed.
Dude, wait, what's on your team? You have a Cresselia, a Stantler.
Yeah, so I got Psychic Normal, you got Dark Water,
right?
Yeah,
one more. What's your other type?
Rock, Bonsly.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, we're good. We can have a team of four.
Yeah, well, not quite. Don't count your chickens before they hatch. Like, I could totally still, like, boof up this encounter and get something that's, like, not camera-upped worthy. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel that. But it's all right. I think
dude, if this typing turns out to be something gross or wrong or whatever, like if it doesn't work, I'm going to be sad because camera ups would be great for you. And just, we need more pairs. We're about to take on the freaking Elite Four, bro. Isn't this insane?
Yeah, it's pretty insane. Come on, get it. What's your
guess? Here it is. Our victory road encounter. Woo. Mail. Here's the mail. It never fails. It makes me want to wag my tail. And when it comes, I want to scream mail. No.
Okay. Oh, thank God. Jesus Christ.
Actually, Psychic would... No, that wouldn't work. I have Cresselia.
Come on!
Here it is.
Caesar!
No. It's a ghost type. Can we say that? Are we allowed to?
No.
Is that cheesing the rules a little to be like,
It's not, because it's not Galarian form.
It's pink, I know.
I don't want to catch it. There's no point anymore.
I think we might as well... I mean, name it after a member, you know, someone part of the temper tantrums. No Charmanders allowed.
I got them. There it is. All right. Camera up. No one has it, so I'm going to name this after Masonator. Woo!
I'm going to name this Corsola after Sky Ruby, and I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
It's a Corsola.
Dude, that's a good Pokemon, man.
Oh, if it's so good, you want to swap out the pair? You want to swap out the Finneon pair?
No, but it's a good backup. That's a solid backup.
It's a solid backup. It is a solid backup.
Yeah, that's right.
It's a cool did mod. They actually make a victory road for Heracold Soul Silver? Is it just as straightforward as Gold and Silver?
No, I mean, it's pretty straightforward, but it's still like victory road.
The original Gold and Silver is so damn straightforward, man. It's whack.
This one's pretty, like, I think you have to fall down at one point, and then that's really it.
I don't even know. Like, it's literally a straight path. So anyways, Tobin.
Yep.
Favorite anime, go.
Haikyuu.
Why?
Because it's the best.
When did you watch it?
Currently watching it.
Like, you're not done with it yet?
No, because it's coming out weekly.
All right, when did it start coming out?
I have no idea.
Okay, when did you start watching it is what I meant to ask.
I started watching it like a couple months ago.
Wait, so like this is like a recent favorite?
Yeah. Like that, I was actually thinking about it. Like I was thinking about this literally yesterday. I was like, what is my favorite anime now? I was like, I forgot. I've been watching Haikyuu. And then I compared it to other animes. I'm like, dude, Haikyuu actually like makes me like super emotional. So I was like, I think it's my favorite for sure.
Let's go.
Because like,
it's not quite Blue Exorcist, but I mean, let's go.
The thing is, yeah. Blue Exorcist doesn't make me emotional. It's a good anime, but it's not like.
Oh, the brotherly love at the end, Tobin. I spoiled the end. Oh God.
Yeah, you did. You did. Of season one.
Not really.
Yeah.
What?
You spoiled the end of season one.
Yeah. Whoops.
That's okay.
It's just season one. I don't know.
Like the thing is, like I always just think of animes that make me like super emotional. Like, and most of them make me emotional at the end, which is like that's a good anime, but like.
Yeah.
But Haikyuu like makes you emotional like every other episode. Like it's super good.
Dude, I should definitely give it a shot. I tried watching ReZero the other day and the opening, it just started off with a character getting hit by a truck and I was like, well, oh God.
That sounds awesome.
It hit me with the feels literally right out the gate and I'm just like, Jesus Christ, why, God, why?
Yeah, it's kinda harsh just to get hit by a truck like that.
Literally, like in the first 3 minutes of episode one, that's a little bit too much, bro.
Yeah,
like, cause when I get into an anime, I was looking for good vibes and I didn't really know what ReZero was.
Yeah, I've never watched it, so I wouldn't really know.
Oh, really?
Mm-mm.
You've seen Blue Exorcist, right?
Yeah, I've saw the first season. I didn't see the second one.
So like, Blue Exorcist is the best anime of all time, right?
Not even close.
The hell, Tobin?
I'm sorry, it's just not. It's good. It's just not like that.
How are we friends,
dude? Naruto Shippuden's way better than Blue Exorcist. You can't even argue.
Okay. I haven't seen Shippuden in its entirety. I've read most of the manga.
You're a Naruto fan.
Yes. All right. Is it bad? I think I'm about to give a Naruto hot take. All right. Any Naruto fans in the comments? I'm sorry. So like, I like the original Naruto better than Shippuden. Is that weird? I think that Shippuden's a better show.
This is why we're stopping in Shoto.
Hear me out. I think that Shippuden is the better show. But yeah. I just have a more nostalgia for the original. Like, that's just a childhood thing.
I think the first, like, the thing is about Naruto, like, it's all right. But, like, after, I'm sorry, spoilers. If you guys want to skip this part, skip the, like,
spoilers.
Ahead, 30 seconds, skip ahead. When Sasuke leaves the village, the rest of the show is pointless. There is nothing that goes on.
Yeah, the rest of the series really just does become, hey, Sasuke! Are you?
Yeah, it's just like, where are you?
Taking 30 episodes to search for Sasuke.
Yeah.
Oh, but I saw him and he ran away.
What's that even that? Like, I don't think they even do that in Naruto. Like, literally, like. Yeah, like, all it is just random missions after that. I'm like, why would you.
Searching for Sasuke, basically.
Yeah, it's just stupid. It's so dumb. I was like, when I was watching, I was like, this is pointless.
Yeah, so, when I rewatched the Chunin Exams arc with Frank earlier this year, no. Here's my thing. I might give a hot take. That has always been, and I'm going to still stand behind this, my favorite anime arc of all time.
Okay.
But I didn't realize how much filler there actually is.
It's
pretty annoying.
Yeah.
I'm not going to cap.
As like, one thing about Naruto, there is a lot of filler, but like.
It is a slow-paced show.
Yeah, but I got to say, like, Shippuden, like, I actually.
They fix it a bit. That's why I'm like, Shippuden's a better show.
Yeah, because it has filler, but like, to me, the filler is at least entertaining. Naruto's filler just sucks. Like,
they reuse a lot of assets from previous shows and previous episodes and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Because, and this is just my guess, I think is because that was a Cartoon Network show and for like Toonami, right?
Well,
I think that they had to like release it weekly and the Naruto writers like, oh God.
Maybe we can't write that fast, like slow down.
Yeah, so we'll put out an episode where it's like 13 minutes of progress, 17 minutes of filler, basically, you know?
Yeah, it was.
Previous episode recaps. or flashbacks and stuff like that.
Yeah, I know that, but that's why like, Shippuden, dude, like there's so many moments you're just like I wanted to cry.
Jaw
like,
dropping, I'm like, 1,000%.
Like, it was just, the ending, dude, the ending, the whole last arc.
Dude, it's so good. Like, again, I haven't seen the entire show.
You need to watch it.
I've read, like, 80% of the manga. Can we do, like, member movie nights, Fire Fam, and the Core Click, where we just watch Naruto Shippuden, start it from the beginning and see how far we can get? It's my thing, Tobin. I'm asking you to do, like, dozens of things.
But
we just never.
Okay, but realize, when you ask things, they're like big, like that's a big commitment to do all 500 episodes.
We don't have to commit. We just have to start it. And then if we want to keep going, we can.
Yeah.
Just with something like that, because it's a long show. If we were to like do like Tokyo Ghoul, it's like, yo, that's 12 episodes.
Yeah, I'm
we
like, that's fine. Like, I can commit myself to that. You know, like we could do like 3 episodes one night, 3 episodes the next. I guess.
Well, like we don't need to commit to a show, especially a 500 episode month.
Come on.
Yeah, like, come on. Because like me and Frank, we still haven't finished that 70 show. I have. I watched the show dozens of times growing up, but Frank, it was his first time, and we're in the middle of season 8 right now.
Yeah, see, I've seen episodes here and there of that, but those just aren't my type of shows. They're just not funny to me. They're just really boring.
You don't like sitcoms? Multi-cam sitcoms?
Uh-oh. I don't like them.
Dude, I grew up on those shows. I'll be honest, that's my type of format.
Yeah, like, I've always just been a big fan. I don't know. I was always just a person who watched sports. I liked watching sports and Sports Center and stuff. That was my thing.
Have you ever seen Drew Gooden? You ever heard of him?
He sounds familiar.
So he's a commentary channel, like, exact... Yeah, I see the deer.
He's dead.
Exact same type of content as Cody Ko, right?
Okay.
I've been binging Drew Gooden lately.
Oh, really?
He does videos, though, where he'll react to things, but then he'll also do, like, breakdown analysis videos on, like, TV shows and stuff like that. And he did a video comparing shows with laugh tracks and shows without. It was a really, really good video. I think you'd actually be into it because that seems like your take on all of these shows. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I'm definitely down to like watch it. If you send me a link, I'll watch it.
Yo, bet. I'm going to do it literally right now.
Do it right now because literally it's about time to start prepping for the Elite Four.
Woo! Elite Four, baby! I know if I don't send this to you now, I just won't send it to you ever. I just know me.
Yeah, no, I forget stuff too. It's all good.
Hell yeah, dude. So Elite Four prep. What you thinking, Tobin?
Well, I got to put away my... Mons that aren't on our team because we have a team of 3.
Yeah.
Here we go. Let's put Shellos away.
So Keyshawn showed me, he did 2 videos on this subject actually. Keyshawn showed me the first one a couple years ago where he compared The Office and Friends. And then this is a video that part 2 came out not too long ago, like a month ago apparently, where it's just called The Death of Laugh Tracks, where they compare like Friends to Big Bang Theory to Young Sheldon. Where even like the spinoff of Big Bang Theory realized that it didn't have sitcom laugh tracks. Why am I talking about this when we're at the Elite Four, Tobin? Shut me up.
No, like we gotta do this. I'm
so sorry.
I'm just thinking, I guess if we just do the first battle, we can do the first battle now.
If you want, we could totally like call this a short episode and then like do Elite Four. Channel.
We can do that. It's always awkward. This always happens when I get to the Elite Four and co-op series. I always get to where there's like 20 minutes when you get here, but then like it's like an awkward time to end it. So
let's start off real quick by like strategizing and figuring out, building the team, getting the items, getting the strat. And then after that, we'll just talk for the next like 5 minutes until we're at 30.
Yep, I am down.
You know what? It's we can talk. So what's the team? Just want to make sure that I get this right. It's Stantler, Cresselia, and Bonsly, right?
Yeah. Actually, since we got here, I can go back and get my Mischievous Encounter and see if we can add
that. Yeah, that's at the Bell Tower.
Yeah, I didn't get that, so I can go try and get that and pair it up, and then we have a team of 4 maybe.
Yeah, let's do it. I have a TM on my Corsola. Like, dude, we can do TMs and stuff. There's some building for the Elite Four on your channel tomorrow. Like, there's a little bit that we can do.
Yeah, let's see. I'm gonna grab Swallop real quick. Man, I wish we could have used him more. He had Motor Drive. That's cool.
There's a lot of Pokemon that we could have used more in this series.
And they're all dead.
Rest in peace. I have a dozen deaths. And yeah, I don't know. It is what it is.
All right, here we go.
I don't know. This has been a fun freaking project.
It has been fun. I think every episode like had a good significance in it.
Yeah. Even this one where, I mean, come on. We're reminiscing and bro talking. I like your nipples, bro.
Dude, your nipples are way better though. Like on a scale of 1 to 10.
I'm not a huge fan of my nipples. I'll keep it real.
Wait, can you get an encounter right here? Oh no.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, I can't go up there. That's so stupid.
You don't have like the rainbow wing or whatever.
Yeah, well, that's so dumb. But you can go to War Islands. This is BS, dude.
Yeah, that's weird. Okay, it's whatever. Yeah. We'll deal with it later. Yeah. So, all right. I have 18 hyper potions. Should I get more?
Because
I'm gonna.
Yeah, why not? Yeah, boom. I think so. I'm trying to think how much I have.
Dude, low-key, it's kind of a strat to do hyper potions and full heals instead of full restore. It's like, yeah, it takes 2 turns, but I have a level 60-something deer.
Yeah, no, like, it's true. Like, it just sucks when there's, like, a thunder-waving mon out, and then you just keep thunder-waving you. At four restore, you can literally just heal all up completely. I prefer full restores.
Yeah.
Like splitting, like my thing is like having like half and half. So like right now I have 27 full restores and 26 hyper potions, and I think that should be enough. But I'm gonna sell some stuff.
Goodbye, Skyplate. Never loved you. Goodbye. Nope. Don't need you. Goodbye, Root Fossil. You will never be resurrected. This Pokemon will never come to life.
Did you really just sell it?
Yeah, I sold a whole fossil. I don't care if it's encounter, bro. We have a deer. We know we're going to get through this Elite Four in the next episode, man.
Right. Dude,
we have a Cresselia pair with a Darkrai and the deer. We're good levels. We're going to win the Elite Four. I'm telling you.
I'm just saying if we lost Pokemon and we need, say when we went to go battle Red on that live stream series and we needed another encounter and that fossil could have been our encounter.
Tolan, you know I want to do Kanto as a video series. We're going to have a talk. My people talk to your people.
No, my people are going to be like, yo, live stream. Because then it'll be fun to do in person to me. That'd be really fun to do in person.
We can do it in person for video. Yeah, I feel awkward. We'll talk about it later.
Yeah, I feel awkward. All right.
Yeah. I'm kind of half paying attention to what you're saying because I'm going through my bag and just selling what I need and what I might not need, you know?
Yeah, I think I'm honestly probably pretty good here.
I'm almost positive I can sell like everything.
Yeah, I'm trying to keep some items for my Pokemon. Like I know Miracle Seed will be good. Cool.
I mean, like, how many items am I going to need? Oh, I could have put, like, Twisted Spoon or the Mind Play on Cresselia, I guess. But I swear to God, I'm literally just going to use the freaking deer. We got a Focus Band. Yeah, that'll be fun.
This man.
Edit, dude. Choice Specs. Boom. Special Attack. That'll be great for Cresselia. That'll be good. And then we can put the Focus Band on the Bonsly, I guess.
Yeah, that'd be perfect. That'd be pretty good.
And then I can keep the Lucky Egg on the freaking Stantler. What's up?
Oh, I thought those glasses boosted accuracy. I was like, oh, hypnosis, but it's not. It's not what I was thinking of. Dang it!
All right, we don't need balls. Well, actually, we might be going to Kanto, so I'm gonna keep the Master Ball just in case. I don't know what's gonna go on with the Ultra Balls.
Yeah, I would keep that. All right.
So how many TMs am I gonna need? I don't think I want Aqua Ring. Wish I mean was cool. We got healing items though, so we don't need that. Tickle's lame. I don't think Jump Kick's gonna be helpful. We'll check that out. Charm, no.
Yeah, I'm gonna just tease some TMs here.
And I think what's going on your game right now, Tobin?
I don't know. I think I'd go with items. Like, I don't think I'll need that many healing items. So I'm just gonna teach. I don't have many good TMs, I don't think.
Yeah, me neither.
Yeah, Ominous Wind.
Misfall is actually really cool. That'll be dope for Cresselia if they can learn it.
Dude, Rigby can learn Ominous Wind, bruh.
Ooh, that's cool. That's cool. I like that.
That actually is so good for him. Okay.
So, okay.
Mega Drain?
Silver Wind. I don't need that. Wake Up Slug. Yes.
Oh, my God. I'll get rid of Synthesis. That's awesome. Okay. We chilling now. We are chilling.
Yeah.
Drill Pack?
Dude, who would have thought? Who would have thought? Entertaining gameplay focused episode. The last few minutes,
dude, you're like, I never know what to do when we get to the Elite Four in these episodes.
There's some prep.
No, it's actually kind of funny because like when I did my verses with third gen, our best episodes like performed well were the ones that were just entirely game focused and like us.
Well,
like,
that's a versus. I think that's the difference, you know?
Yeah, because like it was really funny because like it'd just be episodes where we're like very intensely like right next to each other the whole time. So like we were like, especially towards the end, like I made a comeback and we were like, it was just like I barely won. Like it was,
dude, that's
so
dope
funny.
As hell. Yeah, no, like who was I gonna say? God, I lost my train of thought. Oh, Vinny and Frank's X and Y Soul Link, especially because they were doing that with capture cards, like legit 3DSs.
Oh yeah.
There's no speed up. Do you guys how much like just effing around, I'm not gonna make Matt do a bleep, that they did in that series. Like, yeah, that was just all goofiness the entire time.
No, it
I
was.
Think it's just like the difference between like a versus and a Soul Link. This type of lock type, I think, is just so much more laid back.
Yeah, it's just laid back because you're not. I mean, you're,
laid back.
As long as you're winning, you're fine.
Exactly, which we are. We're big chilling. Yo, can my Bonsly learn Sky Uppercut? I love how I'm not even gonna get this thing to turn into a pseudo Wudo before
you,
the Elite Four.
Ryan, you wanna know why it hasn't evolved yet?
Why?
You got rid of Mimic and you need Mimic to evolve. Like, everyone was commenting that. They're like, Ryan got rid of Mimic. That Bonsly is not evolving.
Can you tell how busy that I've been to the point where it's like I've missed the comment section that much? I can't even teach it freaking fighting type moves.
Nope, he is just a Bonsly. He has effects for it. That's cool.
That is really cool, but he's my HM boy. So we can go ahead. We're going to sell these other TMs.
Oh, my God. That's, they get got some cash money. So cheddars. Funny. When I saw that, I was like, yikes.
I'm terrible. Dude, there was a 2B2 Soul Link episode where Frank legit didn't know that he got a lucky egg, and he went 4 episodes just without
putting it on. Oh, I remember that. Yeah, I'm like, dude, come on.
Dude, he picked it up in the freaking Lavender Town Tower and didn't. Like, I'm telling you, when you record these videos, you just don't notice little things like that sometimes while you're talking. And I guess rest in peace, Mimic. You hate to see it.
Yeah, you really do. But I think.
Here we go.
I think it's about time.
My team's all prepped. I got stuff sold. We got items. Are you all set on your side of things, Tone?
I have all my TMs taught. I have my potions, and we're all good.
Your potions, that's what you're calling it?
Yep, my potions.
Hell yeah, dude. I'm excited. If you guys are excited, let us know down in the comment section. The next episode will be on Tobin's channel tomorrow, and it's going to be the freaking, what, the finale, apparently? Yeah. I don't know, we'll figure out. But we're going to be taking on the Elite Four, so that's exciting. That's some hype. Hopefully you guys are psyched, because I definitely am. Tobin, any final words for the people?
Hit that like button and get ready for an intense finale.
Happy birthday to me.
Yeah, happy birthday, Ryan. Hopefully you had a good day.
Topin. I don't know what I'm doing today. Probably working. I'm crazy.
Yeah.
Catch you all tomorrow. Elite Four run, baby. Let's do this.
And yeah, see you guys later.
Love y'all.
Peace.